This is Eve with American Badass Advocates.org, and I am joining you informally today with some first thoughts on for the candidates running for NAMI National Board and the platform that they're using. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I've got some research going on more deeply into these folks and more over time about this, because there was recently a change.org petition that was going around and they're creating a fluster about this and Shatter the Silence and using horrendously dark marketing, very much in the vein of Autism Speaks. And I felt that was just fucking wrong. And then when I spoke up on behalf of Peer Voice, they said, well, no, we're talking about the 4% of the severely mentally ill who cannot speak for themselves. So we're speaking for them. They cannot speak for themselves. So family and friends and caregivers are speaking on behalf of the 4% of the mentally ill. And diminishing Peer Voice wanting to be involved by, we're not the ones they're talking about. So understand, that's my previous interactions, and I'll go back and look up on that some more and share it later in more detail. So what I want to do here is just give some first thoughts on this DJ Doff. He's scheduled to be at Blue Sky Wellness Center, a center that was created with Peer Model in place and Peer Voice in place, and on wellness and recovery and job skills and placement, things like that. So it's nothing like that now. Oh no, nothing like that now. But now we have this guy who's coming, and he's going to give a speech or a talk and sign books. So, and he's got a book out there. I will figure all that out later and start writing some pieces. But I just wanted to share some first thoughts here. And this is going to be a series of just when I can do it and start, just all I have right now are questions and just what the fuck. So let's see what's happening here, and I would love for my peers to chime in. And what are your thoughts on this? This is National Alliance Mental Illness and their board of directors, and four of the folks on there follow in line with that are up for the campaigns follow this mindset. And so now I understand. I was trying to figure out the NAMI, or the what they were really up to with all this fluster and what was the big goal. I couldn't see the pattern yet, but now it's super obvious. They were wanting to drive a campaign to get people this guy says down here lower, inspired. Wait till you see what he thinks inspires people. It looks like they're trying to pull a coup on this, right? So there's four of them. They're going up to National NAMI Board, and they want to take NAMI back to the glory days, medical model and things like that. So, more about that later. Just a little heads up here. I really need my peers to chime in and figure out what we need to do and focus on this. And yeah, I don't want to go back to the glory days of mental illness, do you? Really? Fuck. All right, so this is the nomination form that is on NAMI National Alliance, or NAMI.org. You can find it there somewhere. But it says, nominated by NAMI of Buffalo and Erie County, New York State. Candidate dude is a member of NAMI of Buffalo and Erie County and NAMI Albany relatives. He has a speech on YouTube, and I'll try and remember to link it at some point to that. I haven't watched it yet, I'm afraid. Whatever. So it says here, I love my sister-in-law, for whom I was a guardian. She has schizophrenia. during her psychotic episodes, I spent nights in ERs because there were no beds for her, and days tracking down housing and treatment programs only to find they won't serve the most seriously ill. I've taken antidepressants. Okay, so how many I's are in his fucking, how many sentences? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many I's? 1, 2, 3, 4. He talks about himself 4 times. Talks about himself 4 times and what he's done. And I don't hear any peer perspective from his sister in this at all. Or anything about her wellness and her ability to anything. I mean, where is she? He's speaking for her, but I don't hear anything of her. I just hear everything of him. So, and then I've taken antidepressants right there at the tail end. What does that mean? You're a peer with us now? And we should include you in peer advocacy? I don't know. Anyhow, it says here, please describe your skills, knowledge, whatever, etc., etc. Using no more than 300 words per driver, which is these little modules that they built that he's answering. So, 5 drivers in the 2015 to 2019 NAMI strategic plan, and there's a link for that and to a PDF. So, I will try to provide that online later as I add things. So driver one says, build a movement. NAMI will broaden public awareness, inclusion in every part of the alliance. Okay, so that's their build a movement driver. This is his response to that. Brought to you after taking some of my medication here. Yeah. I take my meds to you and my antidepressants. And my trazodone so I can fucking sleep at night with prazosin, yeah. So I don't have screaming fucking nightmares all night without actually waking up or sleepwalk or, you know, live in flashback land, yeah. Right. So this is the response to the driver one, build a movement, NAMI will broaden public awareness and inclusion in every part of the alliance. This is this DJ Joff, since I don't know if I've said his last name right, I'm just going to go with campaign dude. As former senior marketing executive and current op-ed writer, I know the best way to build a movement is to inspire people. I'm feeling inspired. Trust and believe. I'm feeling inspired, candidate dude. Because I read number one. Let the public see the horror. So, we're going to inspire people with horror. And this doesn't smell like autism speaks dark marketing fuckaroo to you. Because it does to me. And believe me, my community is still suffering the fucking effects. I have a video that talks about the autistic civil rights movement in our own voice. Maybe you should watch that a bit. Mm-hmm. Fucking dark marketing. Okay, NAMI should broaden public awareness of the horror of untreated serious mental illness. If there is no horror, then why should anyone support more services? But we hide that. For example, NAMI urges the media to not use the word suffer when describing mental illness and rarely show psychotic people in publicly distributed materials. But trying to gain support for the seriously ill by only showing the highest functioning is like trying to gain support for hungry children by only showing the well-fed. You aren't all that brilliant. I mean, just the argument and... Huh? Yeah, maybe let's go back to the autistic rights civil movement. Maybe you should see how we speak about functioning labels and what that means in peer voice. Well, some of us are considered high-functioning, and some of us are considered low-functioning. Some of us can't even fucking be verbal, but we can communicate, and we're pretty fucking badass. So, and those of us who can't speak for the others, who can't speak for themselves, we have a much, much better idea of what's needed in this community. So, don't forget that. But, hey, thanks for playing. So, I am... just gonna finish reading this because I'm just, what a fucking douche. But trying to gain support for the seriously ill by only showing the highest functioning is like trying to gain support for hungry children by only showing the well-fed. Letting the public see the horror of untreated serious mental illness would build awareness of the problem that needs fixing. So let's just make videos of murder sprees. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Murder sprees. That's how we're going to inspire people to help us. Use media reports of violence to propose solutions. When there is a headline grabbing violence, we historically use it to argue that people with mental illness are no more violent than others and more likely to be victims. I got some personal experience on that, motherfucker. Yes, we are. Oh, that's not something you... that's where I'm at with this. Oof. All right. God, the fucking argument is weak. But people with untreated serious mental illnesses are more violent than others, and we should use these tragedies as opportunities to propose solutions, not hide behind platitudes. The best way to reduce stigma is to reduce violence by the minority because it tars the nonviolent majority. I need my medication again. Hold on. I'm gonna medicate this. You know, people were surprised by a fucking email response I got online in regards to the latest advocacy op-ed piece I just fucking wrote in Fresno B's Saturday Opinion. Shut up. You know you do it too. You know it. what was I saying? Fucking, I'm moving on. I'm just, wow, there's like, it's just, this guy wants to go back and make Nami like autism speaks. Everything about us without us speak on our behalf. Let's fucking see what number three says, right? Partner with law enforcement. An individual with mental illness is 10 times more likely to be incarcerated than hospitalized. Yeah. And more likely to be homeless, criminal, arrested, and or suicidal. Right, so, mental health system neglect causes them to become a criminal justice responsibility. Criminal justice officials want to return care and treatment of these individuals back to the mental health system. They are natural partners and influential, so we should build a coalition with them. Huh? We should? Dude! Candidate dude, where the fuck you been? Where you been? What the fuck? Oh shit, balls. We should catch up with the news program people. We're out here kicking ass in law enforcement and first responder relationships, fucking. Proud of our work, so I don't know what you're talking about. I'll make introductions to help Nami do that. Who the fuck are you working with and on whose behalf? Who's testifying or testimonial are you using? I see absolutely zero fucking references to, I mean, I don't see CHP in there listed. Who are you talking about that you're going to partner with? Who are these partners? What can you provide? It was so... high in the sky. What can you do to make that happen? And how? What's your fucking plan? Yeah, okay, I'm gonna stop there, and then the next time I will be able to focus enough to do the Englishing with you all. I will go on to driver 2, leverage technology, and this fucking makes me laugh. I'm sorry, but, you know, I've been with this shit since, what, 95, 94, and then with FresnoMe.com since 96, and high school students got this shit figured out better than the language he's using here. I mean, I just don't get it. Ooh, okay, so we'll end it with that. Check back for more. This is campaign and development, I think, for sure. Love to my peers. Remember, nothing about us without us, and peers at the table.